direction. The first is that after the third piece, there will be a very short pause that you can relax for a moment then. And second, Chris's bio got cut off at the bottom of the program. It should say, and there, Akita Deacon. I'm really, really pleased to introduce instructor of percussion at Portland State University, my partner in the Portland Percussion Group, and very dear friend, Christopher Whyte.
that I'll mention are part of a recent recording project that I'm working on. So three of the pieces that you'll hear tonight are part of that project. The first of which is the next piece I'll play, Psalm 1 by Sarah Hennies, as well as Solo to Anthony Sarum by Lou Harrison, and my own composition at the end of the program tonight, It Colds to Billy, so I'll talk a little bit more about that one later on. Just a note about Umi, Andy Kehoe, if you're not familiar with Andy, is really kind of a big force in classical music right now, and in percussion music especially. He was just this, in the last few months, nominated for a Grammy, and as it turns out, was the runner-up for the Pulitzer Prize in Music for another piece he wrote for Percussion Quartet, which is just a fantastic piece called Seven Pillars, that was recorded by Sandbox Percussion last year. And fun story about Umi, so Andy kind of started splitting time between New York City and Portland a couple of years ago, and before he moved to Portland full time, and when he would come out for a few months at a time, he would stay as close friends with John Thigbini, who's the timpanist of the Oregon Symphony in Portland, and he was staying at John's house for a few months trying to work on a concerto he was writing, and John's dog kept interrupting him, and so he decided to record Umi barking and turn it into this wonderful piece that we have for snare drum now. So Andy's a super creative guy and finds inspiration in lots of wonderful places. The next piece I'm going to play tonight is a work called Psalm 1 by Sarah Hennies. It's a part of a series of pieces that she wrote over the last, starting in about, 2010, of psalms that were pieces exploring slow evolution and space and stillness. And I'll mention that the recording project that I'm working on, it revolves around the theme of stillness. And
Thank you.
concept and aesthetic musically that I wanted to really dig into, that idea of stillness and just different different forms of it, you know, physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally. And so this next piece actually is I'm really happy to play it here because I found out about it from my good friend Terry Longshore. And Lou Harrison was just kind of a giant in our field in percussion music and in contemporary music in general. And in his lifetime, he spent a lot of time in Southeast Asia and was very much drawn to and influenced by the music of follows the trajectory of that process. The first movement is for drums, which is sort of related to the, I thought the skins of the drum heads was a nice tangent, a nice parallel rather to the grapes. I imagine the grapes kind of on the vines in the end of the summer right before they're about to explode, you know? And the second portion of the piece is for all metal instruments. And so that second stage of the process that a lot of wineries use with metal equipment and processing machines that process everything. The third portion of the piece is for all wooden instruments. And so I was conjuring ideas of the oak barrels where, you know, really the wine goes to rest for a long time and just sits there. And I was imagining what that might be like inside a wine barrel where nothing's going on for months on end. And then the last section of the piece is for a series of wine glasses and wine bottles. And so it's been a real joy and a pleasure, you know, trying to learn how to write this piece and to perform it. And so I hope that you enjoy it. The title of the piece is A Cold Stability, which is a reference to the last stage of the process in most winemaking, which is called cold stabilization, where the bottles are chilled down to almost freezing in an effort to not allow any crystals to form in the final product. And that word was just felt so evocative to me, cold stabilization, you know, such an interesting concept. So that's where the title of the piece comes from. And thank you so much for coming. Thank you to Terry for inviting me here. Thank you to everyone in the studio for all your help and all your energy throughout the day. So I hope you enjoy this last piece. Thanks so much for coming. So, no pressure, but if you happen to sneeze, we might all hear that sneeze for a couple minutes in a row. So, enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.